All right, in this video, we're going to be looking at using the Java Jpackager tool. And with the Jpackager tool, you can create an installer for your program. So if you create a cool program and you want to share it with other people, you can have them install it on their computer and they don't have to run it as a jar file. So the first thing we're going to need is a good program. So I've got a little demo program here. And it just opens a swing window. It says testing Java installer, nothing special. But it is important that you have already built your program and that you have a jar file that you can package. The next thing we're going to do, you're going to need to install the Wix toolset, which you can download from wixtoolset.org. And once you have that installed, you will need to modify your system path. So to do that, we can type path here and click edit system environment variables, click environment variables, and then down here in this lower window, double click on path. And then you can click on new and then browse. You're going to want to add the Wix toolset /bin folder to your path. And also make sure you're using JDK 17. And that you have that bin folder added to your path. Also make sure that this bin folder for the JDK is up towards the top. So you can click move up, move it up to the top. And then it will be important to click OK on all of these or it will not save your changes. The next thing I'm going to do is open the command prompt. You can do that by typing CMD. And then I need to navigate to my project folder. So in DOS, you type CD to change directory and then type the path to the directory you want to go to. So if you want to start at the C drive, you can type CD space C colon backslash, and then you can type change directory to whatever directory you want to go to. I put mine in a directory called Java apps. And just as a shortcut, you can type the first few letters of the directory and then hit tab and hit enter and that will take you to that directory. If you want to see what directories are available, you can type dir. I want my demo 2 here. That's what I want to package. So cd demo 2. From this line, I can type jpackage dash h. And that's going to show all of the options that are available with the jpackage tool. So I would take a minute and read over all of these and look at what you may or may not want to do when you're packaging your program, such as you may want to add an icon. You may want to set the version number, other things of that nature. The minimum is going to require that you add the input folder, the directory for your jar file. You can do input or you can do dash I. You need to specify the main jar file. That's the name of your jar file. And then you can also specify a type. So you may want to do an exe. I think that's the default if you don't specify a type, or you can do an MSI. Both of those will give you a Windows installer. So let's try that here. I'm going to type jpackage dash I. And if you're using NetBeans, your jar file is going to be in the dist folder. And then I need my main jar file. And that's going to be demo2.jar for me. You will need to type in whatever the name of your jar file is here. And then to specify a type, you type exe. And it will take a few minutes. And then you will see the command prompt again once it's done. So we can test it out by going to go back to Windows and I'm going to my Java apps and my demo 2 folder. And there it is, my demo 2 exe. I double click on that and I can make sure that my installer works correctly. And now my program has been installed. The default location is going to be in the program files. So I now have a demo 2 installed here that I should be able to run. And there I see my Java program. If you want to uninstall it, you can do that through the control panel like you would any other program. Add or remove programs. And then you can sort by date. And it should be the latest thing you installed, and then you can uninstall it. And that is how you use the Jpackaging tool. Again, you can go through the help and look at the different options here, and you just chain those together like I did right here. Add as many options in there as you want. You can do a shortcut, you can do icons, you can specify the folder that you want the program installed to, and some other cool stuff. But that should get you going. And that's it for this video.